In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit. Amen. The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, and the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all. Good morning, everyone. My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate these sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done, in what I have failed to do. Through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, Ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. And may Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life. Amen. Lord, have mercy. Christ, have mercy. Lord, have mercy. Let us pray. O God, life of the faithful, glory of the humble, blessedness of the just, listen kindly to the prayers of those who call on you, that they who thirst for what you generously promise may always have their fill of your plenty. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever. Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the Acts of the Apostles. The word of God continued to spread and grow. After Barnabas and Saul completed their relief mission, they returned to Jerusalem, taking with them John, who is called Mark. Now there were in the church of Antioch prophets and teachers, Barnabas, Simon, who was called Niger, Lucius of Syria, Manon, who was a close friend of Herod the Tetrarch, and Saul. While they were worshiping the Lord and fasting, the Holy Spirit said, "Set apart for me Barnabas and Saul for the work to which I have called them." Then, completing their fasting and prayer, they laid hands on them and set them off. So they sent forth by the Holy Spirit, went down to Seleucia, and from there sailed to Cyprus. When they arrived in Salamis, they proclaimed the word of God in the Jewish synagogues. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Responsorial Psalm. O God, let all the nations praise you.
O God, let all the nations praise you.
May God have pity on us and bless us. May he let his face shine upon us, so may your way be known upon earth. Among all nations, your salvation.
O God, let all the nations praise you.
May the nations be glad and exult, because you rule the peoples in equity. The nations on the earth you guide.
O God, let all the nations praise you.
May the peoples praise you, O God. May all the peoples praise you. May God bless us. May all the ends of the earth fear you.
O God, let all the nations praise you. Alleluia.
Whoever follows me will have the light of life.
Alleluia. 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 The Lord be with you. A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John. Jesus cried out and said, "Whoever believes in me believes not only in me, but also in the one who sent me. And whoever sees me sees the one who sent me. I came into the world as light, so that everyone who believes in me might not remain in darkness. And if anyone hears my words and does not observe them, I do not condemn him, for I did not come to condemn the world, but to save the world. Whoever rejects me and does not accept my words has something to judge him. The word that I spoke, it will condemn him on the last day, because I did not speak on my own, but the Father who sent me commanded me what to say and speak. And I know that his commandment is eternal life. So what I say as the Father told me." The Gospel of the Lord. Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Morning, everyone. This week we've been reflecting on Jesus Christ as the Good Shepherd that continues to watch us all, his followers, and guides us as we journey his life, as we wander this life. Along the way, we encounter a lot of people. At the same time, we encounter difficulties and problems, and the devil also continues to tempt us to go away from the right path in life. The Lord alone can keep us away from the darkness of sin. That's why we need to have him as the center in whatever we do in this life. He alone can take us away from all these temptations in life that leads us to sin and death. Jesus wants us to follow the right path in life, for he is the way, the truth, and the life. He is the only one who can show us the right path in life, so we can avoid all this unbelief and all this rejection of the truth. As the Gospel says this morning, if we reject him, if we do not follow the things that he wanted us to be, we also reject the Father who sent him. We all know that he came to save us all from sin and all this eternal damnation. And so every day, as followers of Christ, as Catholics, we should do the things that the Lord wants us to be. To be loving and forgiving and kind to everyone. Yesterday we hear also the Lord telling us that he is the light of the world. He is the light that leads us to the right path in life, to our Father in heaven. Jesus is our light and our salvation. And his light enables us to grow in the life that he offers us. If we reject him, we reject the everlasting peace and joy and happiness that he offered to all of us. Jesus' words produce life, the very life of God. And all those who follow him will have it, the very life of God, to those who receive it with faith. To see our Lord Jesus Christ is also to see our Father in heaven. To hear his words is to hear also the voice of the Father. He is the one that enlightened everyone to follow the right path. He is the very light of God that has power to overcome darkness of sin, darkness of ignorance and unbelief. God's light and his truth always brings healing, pardon, and that transformation within us. In the gospel, the Lord warns us that if we refuse his word, or we just take it lightly, and we choose to remain in darkness, Lord says that there is always a consequence in these actions. There is reward if we follow him. There is also punishment in this life if we do not follow him. The Lord brings us abundant life and freedom. Satan will always bring us sadness, anxiety, and all these worries in life. If we reject God, it's like condemning ourselves also of the truth, life, and wisdom. You know, it is one thing to live in ignorance. Those people that really do not know about God's words probably never heard the gospel. But to all of us who heard God's words, already heard the gospel and have knowledge about these things and choose the other way, choose not to follow the very source of truth, then there is consequence of this action. Jesus says that his word, which comes from the Father, produces eternal life and happiness in us. God does not want to leave us in spiritual darkness. That's why he came to save us all. God does not leave us in our ignorance and in our unbelief. Instead, he gives us light, wisdom, and grace to all who follow him, to those who are hungry of his words. And I think that's the reason why we come attend Mass almost every day, because we are hungry of God's words and his grace. And through the gift of the Holy Spirit, he continues to watch us, to help us, to give us that all those things that we need in this life to grow daily in faith and knowledge and understanding of his words. So we continue to reflect this week, Jesus Christ as our good shepherd. Please stand. Now we pray for our church, for our community, and for ourselves. As we continue to pray for the intentions of our Holy Father, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray for all the people here in Susanville, in Harlow, Johnstonville, Jamesville, Doyle area, that we all be protected from this pandemic. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We pray also for the special intentions of Mamen, José, given according to the Santos, for all OFWs working far from their homes, for Edita, for Alan Rice, Rolando Ranua, to Ilek Austin Silverstein, Gina Bañados Aranita, and for the family of Maria Dolores Campos, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear
our prayer. For healing, for Shane, for Leonora, for Mike, we pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. We also pray for all our prisoners who are bound, those who are sick. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
We also pray for the repose of the souls of those who died in our community, also for Manuela, for Gertrudis, for Alfonso, Juanita, Melissa Erfi, and Aileen Monica Adiser. We pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our
prayer. And in the silence of our hearts, let us pray for our own personal special intentions. As we pray also for the repose of the souls of Linda Twiddell, for the repose of the souls also of Jason Hummel and Dave and Maxine Miller, we pray to the Lord. For all those who are sick with coronavirus and all the dying, as we continue to pray for all our medical workers, we pray to the Lord. And all these prayers and intentions we ask through Christ our Lord. Amen. Please be seated. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you. Fruit of the earth and work of human hands, it will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord, God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you. Fruit of the vine and work of human hands, it will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father. May the Lord accept this sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good, the good of all his holy church. O God, who by the wonderful exchange effected in this sacrifice have made us partakers of the one supreme Godhead, grant, we pray, that as we have come to know your truth, we may make it ours by a worthy way of life, through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Lord be with you. Lift up your hearts. Let us give thanks to the Lord our God. It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation at all times to acclaim you, O Lord. But in this time above all, to load you yet more gloriously, when Christ our Passover has been sacrificed. For he is the true Lamb, who has taken away the sins of the world. By dying, he has destroyed our death, and by rising, restored our life. Therefore, overcome with paschal joy, every land, every people exalts in your praise. And even the heavenly powers with the angelic host sing together the unending hymn of your glory as they acclaim. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the font of all holiness. And make holy, therefore, this gift we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew fall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many, for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, Jaime, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her chaste spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coursed to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command and formed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name, thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, O Lord, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever. O Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever. Amen. And the peace of the Lord be with you always. Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. In the body and blood of Christ, give us your prayer. For all those watching this live streaming and cannot receive Christ in the Holy Communion, please join me in this spiritual communion prayer. In union, dear Lord, with the priest of every altar of your church, where your blessed body and blood are being offered to the Father, I desire to offer you praise and thanksgiving. I present to you my soul and body with the earnest wish that I may be always united to you. And since I cannot now receive you sacramentally, I ask you to come spiritually into my heart. I unite myself to you and embrace you with all the affections of my soul. Oh, let nothing ever separate you from me. Let me live and die in your love. Amen. Let us pray. Graciously be present to your people, we pray, O Lord, and lead those you have imbued with heavenly mysteries to pass from former ways to newness of life through Christ our Lord. Amen. And the Lord be with you. And may Almighty God bless everyone, Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen. Our Mass is ended. Go in peace to love and serve the Lord. Have a blessed day, everyone. Come to the feast of heaven and earth. Come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty. Come and sit at my table, where saints and sinners are friends. I wait to welcome the lost and lonely to share the cup of my love. Come to the feast of heaven and earth. Come to the table of plenty. God will provide for all that we need here at the table of plenty. See.